Last week on The X Factor.
I used to think you were such a wonderful man.
Puff the Magic Dragon.
You're very cute.
He shall be.
Tonight, it gets tougher.
Sorry.
Complete and utter mess.
Scarier.
Hi.
Don't you think it's time?
And angrier.
Simon, you are very, very rude.
Than ever before.
Don't push me on you.
It's time.
It was fantastic.
To face.
Yay. Happy 160 when I sing it out.
The music.
It's been very, very harsh. Very harsh.
This, my friends, is the X Factor. Four categories. Four judges.
The auditions have rolled into Belfast, where the hopefuls have turned up in their thousands. As the judges jet off, there is one person who is happy to be heading for home turf.
Today I'm very optimistic because all we need is one person to walk into that room with star quality. I think there's great talent in Ireland, and I know we're going to find that today. It's a beautiful
day. With Belfast ready and optimism sky high, there's a warm welcome waiting for the judges.
I'm honoured to welcome X Factor to our wonderful city. Simon, Sharon and Louise, welcome back.
So as Simon, Sharon, Danny and Louise take their seats, the auditionees are all hoping they can leave their everyday life behind and hit the big time.
Instead of plastering, I want to do well singing.
I can't go back to being a sales assistant.
I want to say goodbye to Tony the cafe owner and say hello to Tony Vegas.
But no one's dreams of stardom are farther away from their day job than the next act. Singing at funerals, it's 44-year-old Michelle and her twin sister Julie.
We do absolutely everything together. We live together, we work together, we sing together.
The twins have travelled to the auditions from Dublin, where their graveside singing has given them some unexpected fans.
The Undertaker's pushing us, go for it, it's a waste. And now it's time to let the world know that we have that gift.
So will their gift help them swap the crematorium for the auditorium?
We could be superstars.
We think we have the ability to do it.
Words can be an express, it'd be like a dream come true.
Can you just stand on the X there, please? What are you guys called?
Girls.
We're Krogan twins.
How old are you?
44.
Do you think you can win the X Factor?
Yeah.
What gives you the to win this competition?
We do funerals and
graveside singing and
graveside singing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What's the favourite song for someone to sing at funerals?
Hymns of the Angels.
What we're singing today.
Okay.
There's always some reason to feel not good enough, and it's hard at the end of the day. In the arms of the angels, fly away from here.
Thank you. I've got to be honest with you, I'd actually want to throw myself in the coffin after that.
Oh.
You sing nicely together, but it's depressing.
So depressing.
You've got, like, that mortuary face on.
Can I be honest with you girls? I think the whole thing's insane. You know, the wigs, The
They're not wigs.
Oh, whatever. It's weird. Wigs, white faces, gloomy funeral songs. Like a couple of corpses.
Let's vote.
Louise.
Yes or no?
Please, just give us one chance.
I'm going to have to say no, guys.
Girls.
Do you take advanced bookings?
For, like, funerals?
Yes, I'd like to book you for mine. At least I know what I'd get.
I'll tell you what, I'll pay for it.
It has to be a no from me.
Simon?
Girls, it's a no.
So it's back to funeral singing for the twins.
No.
And it's a gloomy start in Belfast. As the auditions continue, the twins aren't the only ones to have their dreams buried by the judges.
What's your name?
Tom.
Do you think you can win this competition?
Well, to be quite honest with you, I think I can get to the last three. I want to be the next rock god. Take me to the place I live. Take me all the way.
Tell me you just don't have it to be a great rock singer. It's a no from me, Tommy.
She said you just don't have the rock, and you're even though probably better than Ozzy himself.
It's like pulling teeth! You hit the
door. What's the name of the group?
It's East to West.
Which group in the world would you compare yourselves to?
ABBA, maybe.
ABBA.
Okay.
I keep on searching, but I can't find the courage to show to letting you know I've never felt so much love before. But if I let you go, I will never know.
Why did you choose him as your partner?
Because it's a challenge.
Bloody right it is. Louise?
Never. No.
He was being cocky and we were trying to say that Robert was rubbish and stuff, and it's just not on.
Once again, Louis, you failed to attract the talent.
Darkness falls across the land. The midnight hour is close at hand. Creatures crawl in search of blood.
It's a no.
To terrorize your neighborhood.
It's a no.
Hello. What's your name?
Carol Evans.
Okay.
Who do you think you can be as famous as?
Whitney Houston.
Whitney. Okay. Good luck.
Love can build a bridge. Don't you think it's time? Don't you think it's time?
You're not Whitney Houston.
It's a no from me.
Maybe they don't like Whitney Houston.
Do you know what? I'm completely and utterly depressed and fed up. It's a complete waste of time being here.
So it's been a disastrous day in Belfast. And as the judges take a break, they're wondering if it's even been worth the trip.
I'd rather go to another city and give someone else a chance.
It's the worst day I can ever remember in X Factor. Any audition, anywhere.
Doesn't put me in a great mood, you know?
So with no talent on show, let's hope the next city can deliver.
It can only get better.
Yeah.
Can't get any worse.
Still to come on The X Factor.
I feel wild and sexy when I sing a song.
It's crazy.
It's crazy. I think this is crazy.
Simon, you are very, very rude.
Welcome back to The X Factor, where everyone is hoping to dance their way to the top. And one person who hopes she can dance herself into the next round is 30-year-old dance teacher Shelley from Doncaster.
The reason I'm here today is I know that I've got something and I know I am a good entertainer. I do think I have a spark. And I'm just hoping that they'll appreciate exactly what it is I've got to deliver and show them.
And you can dance. Why did you enter today?
Basically, Simon, I'm a trained dancer, but I really want to see whether I've got anything else to offer, sweetheart.
because I'm also always at the back of the queue.
It's
been a long
time
since I've had an opportunity, you know, to do something like this.
Yeah, you want to be at the front of the queue?
I do, yeah, I do. Definitely, yeah.
Okay, are you any good?
I think I'm okay, sweetheart, yeah.
You got a great body.
Thank you, my darling.
What are you going to sing?
Okay, Liberty X. Is that okay?
Yep.
Love it.
Yeah, all right?
Yep.
Okay. Oh, baby, won't you work it a little, get hot just a little, leave me in the middle, let go just a little bit more, give me just a little bit more. Ooh, yeah, baby. Work it a little, yeah, hot just a little, leave me in the middle, let go just a little bit more, give me just a little bit more. Thank you.
That's what it's all about. Did you like
Thank
that,
you,
Louis?
Yeah, it was very nice. You're a great dancer.
Thank you, sweetheart.
Yeah, like a pussycat doll you are.
I want to be a pussycat doll, Sharon.
You are one.
Please.
Can I ask you something from one woman to another?
Of course.
Do you do topless dancing?
I do, darling, yes.
Good for you.
Are you doing topless dancing now?
Pardon? No, darling, I teach.
So you're not doing any topless dancing?
No, darling, no.
Okay, okay, all right, we better vote. Sharon?
Oh, yes, absolutely.
Thank you, Sharon.
Danny?
Yeah.
Thank
Louis?
You,
yes.
Thank you.
Four yeses.
Thank you, darling. You've made my world.
Pleasure, darling.
Okay,
thank you. All right.
Bye. It's like my dream come true, and I'm on my way. I'm on the right path, wicked.
She's fabulous. I love her.
Surprised you haven't seen her before.
And Shelley's yes seems to give everyone that X Factor feeling.
Hey, what are you girls called? An aphrodisiac. And do you think you can win this competition?
Yes, it's about time that a band won, I think.
In your own time.
Boom, bang, boom, bang, bang, boom, bang, boom, bang, bang. Now do your thing.
I think you're a bit nuts. I like that.
I'm going to say yes.
You're through.
Your name is?
Christian Lund.
Tell me everything about you.
I'm 14.
Yeah.
And I love singing. I've been singing since I was six.
All right.
Can you feel the love tonight?
You've got a really sweet voice and we've all fallen in love with you.
Yes.
I have to say yes.
What's the name of the group?
Trinity.
Mum, Dad and Daughter?
Yes.
Oh, cool. Off you go.
Yeah, and Debbie. He's my brother.
I'm a brother.
Yeah, I think you could win the X Factor on your smile alone.
I really, really like you.
Yes, yes, yes.
Oh! And will 16-year-old student Kimberly from Manchester carry on the yeses?
Why are you here today?
Everything I've ever wanted.
Okay. So what are you going to sing?
Ain't No Mountain High Enough.
Off you go.
Baby, there ain't no mountain high. Keep me from getting to you, babe.
Kimberly, I thought you were terrific. Very commercial, very well prepared. You look terrific.
Yes.
Yes.
Four yeses. Well done.
This is brilliant, isn't it? It's just my dream and it's everything I wanted to do, so hopefully it'll carry on. It's really good.
So Kimberly is on her way to boot camp, and the yeses are flying through. The X Factor is open to all ages, and proving you're never too old to follow your dream is 70-year-old shop worker Maria. Maria has been writing songs for 7 years, and today she's brought one of her own to impress the judges. And she's even brought the lyrics.
I've done that because so everybody can sing with me. I want the world to sing with me.
I
love you all, and I want you to sing this song with me.
Tell me something interesting about you.
I've wrote lots of songs, and I want some songs everybody to hear.
Okay.
Yeah?
Off you go.
Right. Now, this one calls Wild and Sexy. Yes.
How old are you, excuse me? How old are you again?
I'm 70.
Ah, this is ridiculous.
You are 70.
This is inappropriate.
Okay, in your own time.
I lost every penny, my pocket as a whole. But if you can play a tune, you can earn a pound or two. Won't take you to the moon, but you can buy bread and food. Yeah. I feel wild and sexy when I sing a song. I feel wild and sexy when I sing along. I feel wild and sexy when I sing a song. I feel wild and sexy when I sing along.
I'm not being rude, but this is inappropriate.
It's nice songs.
What? It's a, yeah.
Yes. It's me who wrote it.
Oh, you wrote it.
I wrote it. And what I want, I've done a lot of CDs up to now.
Yeah.
And everybody wants to buy it because I'm playing a mashup.
How many have you sold?
I haven't sold any, but loads of people have got it. Friends, a lot of friends and family.
But no one's
right?
actually bought one.
And I want to be professional, buy best quality.
Look, Maria, nobody, darling, is going to buy that.
Hey, well, it must like some of it.
All right, Maria, look, we're going to vote, sweetheart. Louis, yeah. Yes or no?
Please.
You can't turn that down.
Louis?
I'm going to have to say no.
No.
I'm going to have to say no.
Sharon.
Oh, darling, it's a yes from me.
Danny.
Yes.
Danny, you're professional.
Maria, I've got to absolutely put a stop to this for a number of reasons, so I'm going to say no.
Why not?
I can't hear any more. I'll give you a handout with your lyrics. Come on.
I want to know why.
Because the songs are terrible, Maria.
The songs are terrible.
Come on, I'll give you a hand with this. You've got travel down the road back. You're not stealing the lyrics, Louis.
So it's a no for Maria. But outside in the holding area, spirits remain high. Next up, and desperate for a yes, is 20-year-old Sam. Having grown up in a small corner of Newcastle, he never thought he'd get his chance of following his dream. Until today.
I came here today to the X Factor, try my hand at singing, you know, in the X Factor. People around us, like my family and friends, have said that I've got something, so I'm going to take them up on that offer, you know, see how far I can go. When I perform, I feel like I'm a different person, you know. I get away from the weight and the weight on my shoulders, you know, it takes it off it, so see how it goes.
Hello, sir.
Hello.
And your name is?
My name's Sam Donaghy.
And what makes you different from everybody else outside?
To be honest, you know, I feel like when I perform, I just feel like the world's off my shoulders. I feel like a completely different person when I sing.
What are you going to sing?
Handbags and the Glad Rags.
Okay.
Ever see a blind man cross the road, trying to make the other side? Ever see a young girl growing old,
20.
Trying to make herself a bride? What becomes of you, my love, when they have finally stripped you of the handbags and the glad rags that your poor old granddad had to sweat to buy you?
Okay. I think you're great. I really do.
I love your voice. I love the tone in it. And I think you will absolutely sparkle being helped with the right songs. I love you. I think you're fantastic.
Thank you very much.
That's all I have to say.
Bit on the fence there.
That was worth waiting for. So we're going to take a vote. Lulu?
Yes, yes, yes.
Danny?
Yes.
Simon?
100% yes.
Yes from me. Four yeses.
Thank you so much.
Very good.
I got through, yes.
He could be absolutely brilliant.
Brilliant singer. Just a good old-fashioned good singer.
So Sam is one step closer to following his dream of becoming a star. And as the judges continue their audition tour, they think they may have found someone special.
I just thought he had some kind of a star quality thing about him.
You offered to help him.
I think girls would like him a lot.
The whole room was lifted and then it was like, yeah.
Still to come on The X Factor.
Like Shane Ward and Leona Lewis, they've got no charisma.
Have you got a heart?
Yes, but I've also got a brain.
Where's your brain in your middle toe?
Now it's your chance to be a winner with The X Factor. Every 2 weeks, we're giving one lucky winner the chance to win the latest in home entertainment with this superb 32-inch LCD TV, a home cinema system, a video iPod, a Nintendo Wii, a Samsung mobile phone, and tickets to the X Factor live tour. All you have to do is guess the missing word from this classic audition.
This time I know it's for...
For your chance to win, either call 0901 293 0700 or text the missing word to 84066. Digital satellite viewers can press red. Calls cost £1 from BT landlines, but may cost more from mobiles and other networks. Text messages cost £1 plus one standard rate reply message. Lines close at 9 a.m. Saturday, 15th of September. Entries made or received after this will not be counted but may still be charged. Good luck. Welcome back to The X Factor, where the auditions are back in Birmingham. With Sharon away on business in LA, the auditions continue with Simon, Louis and Danny. And the Brummies are all putting in final preparations for their moment in the spotlight.
They can't take away my dignity.
But no one has come more prepared than the next contestant.
Doe, a deer, a female deer.
45-year-old IT worker Alison has been preparing for her audition for the last 3 years with the help of her vocal coach, Andrew.
Right from here.
It's been an awful lot of work. I've had lessons continuously for about 3 years. I've lost a stone in weight. I've had to have my hair done, nails. It's been quite a journey. My vocal coach thinks I've got the range and I've got the power. I've got the technical capability to do the things that are being asked of me.
I think she can get a long way in the competition. Only Alison knows if she can win it.
Do, re, mi, fa, so, la, di, do, so, do.
Hi.
Hi, sweetheart. What's your name?
I'm Alison.
And why are you here?
Because I've practiced an awful lot and I've worked really hard to do it. I've been having a vocal coach who has turned me from being a person who sings in a choir into hopefully somebody who can perform.
Is he supportive?
He's just outside waiting for me.
Well, bring him in.
Really?
Why not?
Yeah.
If he's the rock, bring him in.
They want you in here.
They want me?
Come and stand by Alison, please. And what's your name?
My name's Andrew Sparks.
Andrew Smart. And how long have you been working with Alison for?
Oh, 2.5 years now, I suppose.
And what's she like?
When she started, she was very shy.
Yeah.
And she's worked and worked and worked and focused. And she's passionate about it, which is why I've worked so hard with her.
And do you think she can win?
I think she would stand a shot.
Okay, what are you going to sing?
I'm going to sing Beautiful by James Blunt.
Are you?
Yes.
Okay.
My love is brilliant, my love is pure. I saw an angel, of that I'm sure. She smiled me on the subway, she was with another man. But I won't lose no sleep on that, cause I got a plan. You're beautiful, you're beautiful, you're beautiful, that's true. And I saw her face in a crowded place, and I don't know what to do, cause I'll never be with you. She cut my eye.
Thank you. And what were you like before you had singing lessons? I mean, it was extraordinary.
In a bad way?
Yes.
Andrew, what do you think?
I think anybody who has got the passion has got a chance to go a long way in X Factor.
Andrew, I'm not being rude here, but I think the word refund comes to mind here. I mean, seriously. I mean, it wasn't even human. It was just ridiculous.
How much are singing lessons?
A session is £18, Louis.
It's a waste of money.
You've just absolutely broken me. I did actually think that there was something there.
Nothing.
All right, we're going to vote. Louis, yes or no?
No.
No.
Thank you. Thanks. What you said hurt, but I'm going to continue singing.
That was uncomfortable. I'd like to teach the
world to sing. And after Alison, there are plenty more hopefuls whose vocals sadly failed to impress the judges.
Hey there. Who would you like to be as good as?
Tina Turner.
Okay.
I would do it for you. Whatever you want me to be, yeah.
I don't even think this would work in a hotel. I think they'd leave the bar. I'd like to teach the world to sing in
perfect harmony. And how long have you been together?
6 months.
Who do you think you could be as big as?
Hopefully, Girls Aloud.
Okay.
Let me see you through, cause I've seen the dark side too.
And when the night falls on you, baby.
Girls, can I be honest with you? It was a complete and utter mess. It was like four cat's tails being trapped in a door simultaneously. Never mind.
For me, it's a no.
No.
I'm going to say no.
Hi. What's your dream?
To become a number one artist.
Okay.
I don't know what you're waiting for. Your time is coming, don't be late. Hey, hey, so come on. See the light on your face. Let it shine, just let it shine. Let it shine.
Well, Andy, you didn't.
Singing is not for you.
Oh.
At all.
At all.
Okay.
Well, Birmingham hasn't delivered so far. I would just like somebody individual to walk in the door.
Well, Simon, maybe this next contestant is just what you're looking for.
I'm here today to offer what the X Factor is missing.
It's 18-year-old supermarket worker, Matthew.
I think the X Factor needs a showman, not just a singer, but a pop culture phenomenon. I'm not just offering a voice, I'm also offering a very big personality.
Oh, come on, Benny!
And if I could win this competition, I believe I could be genuinely the next Robin Williams.
And what's your name?
Matthew Bennett.
And Matthew, what's the dream?
Well, I don't mean to be disrespectful, but like Cheyenne Ward and Leona Lewis, fantastic singers, brilliant, but when they get on stage, they've got no charisma. They get on stage and all they do is like, oh, this not. This one's Leona. This is Shane. But I think they need something different. They need a showman.
Right.
Yeah. I've got loads of charisma. When I get on stage, I just rip it up. Got the whole package.
So you want to be a star?
I honestly do believe I'm a star. I watch people on TV and I think I could do a better job than that.
Good. Okay. Good. What's the song?
I'm doing a little collaboration.
A little medley.
A little medley, indeed.
Off you go.
Thank you.
Believe when I say that I want it that way. Lean on me when you're not strong, and I'll be your friend. I'll help you carry on. Something inside so strong.
Yo.
Okay. Well,
I was enjoying that.
You cannot fault this guy's confidence.
Absolutely.
That's what I'm here for.
I know.
Yep. I give you that.
Thank you.
Robbie's not the best singer in the world, but he's got confidence.
Yeah, that's what it's all about.
A little bit corny, the song choices, but...
Yep.
Listen.
Yep.
You could either be great or you could be on Butlins. I haven't decided.
Okay.
When you stamped your foot and were clicking, it reminded me, you know, of a one-man band where they've got things attached to their arms and legs, and I could imagine the cymbals going and the drum... on your back.
That's what it's all about, yeah.
No, it's not. It's not all about that.
That's all I could picture.
I think you're a great karaoke singer.
Very karaoke singer. Maybe should have sung a different song, but
okay.
Yeah.
I mean, look, pre-warning here.
Yep.
There are tons of better singers than you we've already put through.
Yeah, but maybe not tons of people with better confidence.
Louis, yes or no?
Please. No.
Well, calm down.
No.
You don't think so? Oh.
I'd hate to work with you in boot camp.
No, honestly, okay.
All right, Danny.
Yes.
Thank you. Simon.
I'm going to say yes.
Thank you!
Off you go. Off you go. Off you go.
You've got too much confidence, man.
You can't have too much.
You have.
What do you want? You just want a bunch of shy little people who are just going to obey you in the next round.
No, that's you.
That is you. I feel fantastic. Thank you very much for coming by. Robbie Williams, watch out.
Outside, the hopefuls continue to arrive, all hoping that the X Factor can change their life forever. One person desperate for that chance is 23-year-old mum of three, Kelly from Walsall.
I've not just got the X Factor, I have got the wow factor.
She has got 100% star quality, she will go places.
I will shout, Simon, who's the biggest and who's the best? And that I will win this, no matter what.
Go on, good luck.
Okay,
there.
Kelly.
Go
for it. Do your best, please.
Hello.
Hi, Mum.
How are you? Good, this is Danny, this is Louis.
Hiya, hi Louis.
How you doing?
Okay, what's your name, darling?
Kelly Norfolk.
And why are you here?
Because I've got the X Factor.
Which is?
Me.
Okay.
I might not have the looks, but I've got the X Factor.
And who would you compare yourself to in the charts today?
Celine Dion, Whitney Houston, Mariah Carey.
And how would you mark yourself out of 10 in terms of vocals?
10 out of 10.
Good. What are you going to sing?
I Will Always Love You.
Off you go, Kelly.
She'll make you cry. Sing it.
If I should stay, I would only be in your way. So I go. Of you every step of the way, and I will always love you, will always love you.
Thank you. Well, you sounded like a dog barking
sorry,
at the end.
I am so sorry.
Kelly, it was... I mean, you sang it in about 7,000 different keys. I think this is a pointless exercise. You haven't got a 10 out of 10 voice. At best, I would give you 2.5.
Thank you very much,
Simon. And that's being Kelly. Generous. Danny?
I can see you're really nervous, but I don't think you have the voice to win the X Factor.
Kelly, you're a nice girl, but your voice is just not as good as you think it is.
So it's a what?
It's a no.
No, okay. Not for me.
Okay, nice to meet you, Kelly.
Thank you very much.
Bye, sweetheart.
Thanks a lot.
What did she just say?
Very degrading. Could not be nicer. I think I'm being penalised because he just wants to get home. He's not giving anybody a chance. He seems to me very he wants to get home. He wants to go to the pub, basically.
10 out of 10 Whitney Houston, Mariah Carey, Celine Dion. And that sounded like Lassie.
Hi, Simon.
How do you do?
I'm her dad, her father.
What's your name?
Peter.
Peter. She was absolutely terrible in here, Peter. Can I say something? You are partly to blame for your daughter's delusion.
Why?
Because you've obviously encouraged her. It's crazy.
It's crazy. I think this is crazy.
No, but the whole thing is crazy.
Simon, all I'm asking you, please, can you give her one more?
It's
one more,
pointless.
Just one more.
It's pointless,
why
Peter.
Is it pointless? Because I know she can do it.
Peter, you don't. That's the whole point. You don't know.
I do.
This is my business. Your daughter isn't good enough.
Have you got a heart?
Yes.
Well, will you put your hand in your
but
heart?
I've also got a brain.
Where's your brain? In your middle toe.
Goodbye, Kelly.
You've been very, very harsh.
Nice to meet you, Kelly.
Very harsh.
Kelly, reality check, it's enough.
You all you want to do is just go home, don't you?
Just believe. Basically, you penalise your affair.
Kelly,
you just what I want to do. Thank you. Don't push me, I'm walking.
Okay, come on. I will shout you, Simon. Thank you. Simon, you are very, very rude. Oh,
there's an eye opener.
Being very rude.
Very rude. Thank you. Good work.
I could have earned Simon millions. Just think about it, Simon. When I'm big and famous, you could have been earning the money with me.
Still to come. on The X Factor.
Wow.
I'm ready to win this.
Not the best I've seen today.
Was she good?
Welcome back to The X Factor. This is the first year that 14 and 15-year-olds have been able to enter the competition. And for 15-year-old schoolboy Dominic, today could see his dream come one step closer.
In school, we were given a sheet to say where we want to be in 5 years. And my number one thing was to have a number one album and number one single. And just to fulfill my dreams, really. But singing means everything to me, really, because I've had a lot of support from my family, friends, and they actually tell me I can sing. So I really want to do this to make my mom, my nan, the whole of my family proud, really, and pay their faith in me.
So is Sharon back from LA and his family there to support him? It's time for Dominic to face the judges.
Hello. How are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
It's a drag, isn't it?
Oh, dear.
Right, what's your name?
I'm Dominic.
Dominic, how old are you?
I'm 15.
15. Now, who are you here with, Dom?
I'm with my mum, my nan, and just the rest of my family.
Yeah?
Yeah.
And what are you going to sing, Dominic?
And Mac the Knife.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. Oh, the shark, babe, has such teeth deep, and he shows them pearly white. Oh, just a jackknife has old MacKeith, babe, and he keeps it out of sight. Oh, the line forms on the right, dear, now that MacKeith's back in town.
Wow. You're a talented young man, Dominic.
Thank you.
I think he's a natural talent. For 15 years, really loved it.
Thank you so much.
Sharon?
Yeah. Dominic, it's so great for somebody of your age to come in and you look so hip, but you've got great taste in music and you're your own person. It's just you. You're really refreshing.
Thank you.
I really love your voice, but I also love your body language, the way you move. It's just your own thing and it's so nice to watch.
Okay, moment of truth now. A lot of talented people your age gone through.
I am a tall tree. If Dominic does get through this round, it will mean so much to him. I am a
giant. Sharon, yes or no?
Yes.
Danny?
Yes.
Louis?
Absolutely yes.
You need three. Look him in the face and say, you got four. Nice to meet you, Dominic.
He's like a young Nat King Cole, isn't he? He could do really well, guys.
Lovely boy.
Love them. Love them.
I feel absolutely fantastic. I've made my family proud of you.
Super talented.
And Dominic's yes is just the first of many.
Love is a wonderful thing. Make you smile through the pouring rain.
One step closer to my dream.
That's where you find me.
Absolutely thrilled, over the moon, really proud.
Just too far from where you are.
Four yeses, come on! Yes!
Oh, hush.
Little baby, don't you cry.
I'm ready to win this.
Can you feel it? Say the greatest, yeah. Can you feel it?
It's the end of the day in Birmingham. And one of the last contestants to see the judges is 28-year-old Natasha and her 7-year-old daughter, Jasmine. And Natasha needs her dream to come true more than most.
This is Jasmine. She's my 7-year-old daughter. And she's been through with Mummy, haven't you? Supporting Mummy. Yeah? And you want Mummy to win.
Being a single mum means Natasha has no one to look after Jasmine. So they will be facing the judges together.
It's really important for me to get through today. It's putting the past behind me and actually seeing for the future and helping myself and my daughter get a better life. I'm really nervous right now.
Hi, how are you?
Okay.
What's your name?
My name's Natasha Benjamin.
Okay, now how come you brought Mrs. in with you?
We've been through a lot in the last couple of years. And I feel that I've put her through a lot, and And right now is like a turning point for me, and I wanted to see her mum actually achieve and actually get on further in life.
So why has it been so bad?
I left a violent relationship, and it actually got to the point where a weapon was actually used and I could have lost my life. And since then I've moved away from my home, my family and everything, and everyone's been telling me for years to do the X Factor, but I don't know, I've always sang, but I've never sort of taken that step.
Would your daughter like to come up here with us and watch from here?
Yeah, go on.
Trouble. You want to be a judge?
Yeah. Stand in here.
Right in the
stand
middle
in here with
to
us.
Watch Mummy.
Okay.
Alright, so what are you
right,
going
no
to
no laughing and you can't be mean.
No laughing, you can't be mean.
Right.
I'm going to sing Toni Braxton, Unbreak My Heart.
Okay.
So we've got
don't leave me in all this pain. And don't leave me out in the rain. Bring back those nights when I held you beside me. One break my heart. Say you love me again. Undo this hurt you caused when walked out the door and walked out of my life. I could cry these tears. I've cried so many, many nights. Unbreak my heart.
Was she good?
Yeah.
All right. Sharon?
You've got a lot of passion, but not the best I've seen today.
You know what? I would love to hear you sing about happy things.
Yeah. Yeah.
Because I think that's what you naturally are, a happy person.
Yeah. Do you know that? So touching, because that's sort of what's happened, because normally I would sing. Sorry.
You've got a good voice. I think it's a lot better than you think. I just think you've lost your confidence with everything. And I liked you.
Well, we've got a vote.
We've asked Jasmine as well.
Yeah, I'll say brilliant.
Oh, okay.
Oh, brilliant. Okay.
Sharon, yes or no?
Do you know what? I don't think you've had a lot of breaks in your life. I'm going to give you a break now and I'm going to say yes.
Danny?
I wholeheartedly give you the biggest yes.
Jasmine?
Yes.
Louis?
Absolutely yes.
Nat, you're a fighter. You got 5 yeses, you're through.
Jasmine, take care of your mum.
No.
God, did she need a break?
Totally.
No matter what you go through, you can still succeed if you keep trying and don't ever just give up.
Coming soon on The X Factor.
X Factor.
Hallelujah.
I want to talk to you.
I'm not sure that was the right decision.
All by myself anymore.
You're a pub entertainer.
Listen, don't call me a pub singer. You're talking stupid.
Next.
I can't believe we've got so much in the show.
I can't believe it either.
How are we going to fill it all in?
Suppose we're going to have a get you speaking like this.
What are you talking about? Speaking like what?
Speaking like this, without any pauses.
Well, how are we going to get from one part of the studio to another part? This quick.
Easy. See?
Ant and Dec's Saturday Night Takeaway. Whilst next, over on ITV2, The Extra Factor.